What's up, girls and boys? It's me, Bianca, and I am back with another Story of Seasons Pioneers of Olive Town video. For today, I will be showing you guys an effective way to start your life in Olive Town with this guide on what to do with the first 7 days in the game. Begin, let's talk about the difference between normal and seedling difficulty. Seedling is essentially the easy mode of the game, which allows you to lose less stamina, gain skill levels and friendship quicker, earn more money, and you know, where items are cheaper in stores. Apart from that, there's really no difference in the game. Time moves as it normally does, with each real life second equating to a minute in the game. So if you want to make things easier on yourself, you can start off with seedling mode for the first 7 days of the game, then change your difficulty to normal later when you get the hang on how to do things and when you've formulated your own schedules. With that out of the way, let's begin. After watching through the long introduction and creating our character as well as naming our farm, we're finally given control of the game. The game starts off at 12 noon, which should give us enough time to do a couple of things. The first and most important of all is to gather enough wood, stone, and grass to fix the coop. So we do that first while foraging for items we can sell. Remember that foraging and shipping what you've foraged is very important, especially in unlocking what stores are selling. Fixing the coop requires 20 wood, 20 stones, and 30 grass. So we use our axe on trees to get wood, our hammer on the rocks scattered about to get stones, and our scythe to get grass from the weeds. During this time, since we selected seedling, our skill levels increased. Also, there is a chance for us to get a couple of earth sprites as well. Once the coop is finished, we can choose to move it to a different location by pressing B to clean it up and just selecting the coop in our item palette and heading to the location we want it to be transferred to. Note that if you decide to do so, the game will require you to input a name for it again. Also, if you already tamed animals prior to moving farm facilities, you will need to ungroup them from that particular facility. With the coop now operating, we can finally tame the wandering hen in our farm. We do this before 5 p.m. so that we can get them to graze, which in turn gives us a chance to obtain an egg to sell the next day. Now that the coop is out of the way, the next order of business is heading to the town proper to obtain two of the extra tools we can get at this time, the fishing rod and the camera. Head to Marcus's house first to get the fishing rod since it's closest to you. Now we get the camera in the museum, making sure not to forget to head to Olive Hall as well for the first request we can get, as well as to obtain the rewards we may have unlocked thus far. At this point, you can also head to the shrine area if you want, as a fox sometimes spawns there for you to take a picture of. Likewise, you can talk to the villagers you encounter. I do make it a point during my own playthroughs not to go out of my way to talk to all of them during this first day. Once we've done our business in town, we head back to our farm. We should have enough time to chop just enough wood to craft our first lumber maker. We do so as we will need lumber soon enough. Here's a tip for you guys if you're following along. Make sure that you don't run out of stamina. Stopping at one heart remaining or half a heart remaining is good enough, provided that you sleep before 10 p.m. in order to fully replenish your stamina. Now on to the second day. We will get more tools as well as seeds for farming from Mayor Victor in day 2, as well as a, to get us started. Before we go planting our first crops, however, the first thing we should do every morning is check up on our livestock. If it's sunny, let them graze. Otherwise, feed them fodder. And since we already have a hen and it's sunny, we're letting Egberta go and graze before we pet her and get our first egg inside the coop. It is only after checking up on our livestock that we go about plowing the field and sowing the seeds we got from Mayor Victor. Also, we select a good spot to place the well in. The closer to the sown seeds, the better. We head to the town again to check on the requests and gain the rewards we've unlocked. We also head to the museum to hand over whatever we can donate to increase the number of tourists. After that is done, we go back to the farm and see what we can forage while working on chopping more wood to feed the lumber maker. We need to make 20 lumber in order to fix the bridge and gain access to the second area of the farm where the barn, mushroom log, and new wild animals as well as forageable items are located. The remaining 5 lumber, since we only need 15 to fix the bridge, is for making the storage box. Now, while the lumber maker is processing, we can go ahead and explore the town some more, talking to villagers and trying to get wild animals to spawn by the shrine, or we can fish. The point is, we can do whatever we want at this point, just keep an eye out on our stamina. If it gets too low and there's still much for us to do, we can head to the cafe or the bistro to eat and replenish our hearts. Now, I actually managed to get the 15 lumber needed to fix the barn, but I forgot to head to the bridge to actually fix it, which pushed back things for me in this recorded playthrough. If you manage to fix the bridge in day 2, then you'll gain access to the second area of the farm in day 3. Anyways, let's go to day 3. For day 3 for this particular save file, as I've mentioned, I forgot to fix the bridge, so today's the day for me. Also making the storage and spelunking in the mine. As usual, we do our farm chores. The coop first, then watering the crops, before we go and forage and work on whatever else needs working on. Then we head to the town again and to Olive Hall and the museum while talking to the villagers we meet along the way. For the first mine, there are only 10 levels and it's quite easy to get to the bottom level in our first try. We only need 2 tools for exploring the mine as well. The hammer for smashing boulders and ore deposits, and the hoe for digging up the ground where you can see ores sticking out. Grab as many iron ores as you can. We will need this to build the ingot maker in order to get the iron for upgrading our tools and fixing the barn. Note that if you find unpolished gems, don't sell them. You can make more money by storing them for now and processing them in gem makers later on in the game. You can also choose to fish during this time. Just a tip, don't sell the first of each type of fish you catch. Donate them instead to the museum, again to increase the number of tourists. Also, try to chop as much wood as you can. We're aiming to upgrade from the tent to the log cabin ASAP as well. Day 4! Today is the day the bridge gets fixed. But before we go and explore Area 2, we must first work on our chores in the initial area of the farm. That is, after the mayor tells us about upgrading our living conditions, which we can't really do at this particular day because Nigel's shop is closed during Wednesdays. Bummer. Anyways, once we're done with our chores and the usual heading off to town to check on the requests, get rewards, and donating to the museum, along with talking to villagers we meet, we head off to the newly unlocked area of the farm. Here we have the barn waiting to be fixed. It needs 10 hard lumbers, 10 iron bars, and 50 flexible grass, all of which can be found in this area. Be careful with chopping trees here, since there are now two kinds. The one that drops the hardwood are the trees with a darker shade of leaves. Unless you have a whole army of makers at this point, it's quite challenging to get all the required materials in just one day. And that's fine, really. Just make sure that you process what materials you could. The quickest way you can fix the barn, if you focus in fixing it first before upgrading your tools, is 2 days. Also, be sure to have 20 wood ready for upgrading the tent to the log cabin before you go to bed. The fifth day is for upgrading our house from the tent to a log cabin, as well as fixing the barn. Again, this could have been done quicker if we didn't forget to fix the bridge in day 3. But before we go to Nigel, we have to first deal with our daily routine, our farm chores, and heading to Olive Hall. Be sure to have that 20 pieces of wood with you as you leave for the town so that you don't have to backtrack like I did. With the house upgraded, we can now get the leash from Patricia at the animal shop. With that tool in our possession, we are now only missing one more, the bucket. But more on that later. For now, we go back to the farm to complete the rest of the requirements for the barn. Again, try to do this before 6 p.m. so that you can get the cow, which you can tame at the second area of the farm, and get it to graze and get a chance to milk it the next day. Also, while you wait, try to get as much iron as you can to prepare for upgrading your tools. Or you can opt to fish if you want to earn more money during this time. We're now at the sixth day, and we lucked out with today's weather being rainy. This saves us a lot of time with watering the crops. This also means our animals won't be grazing, so we take some fodder with us to go and feed Egberta and Mufasa. We also harvest our first batch of turnips. Once again to Olive Hall and the museum we go after doing everything we can in the farm. The main point of this day is upgrading our rucksack and our tools. Now, depending on how many iron bars you have as well as lumber, then you may be able to upgrade all of them into iron tools. If you only have materials to upgrade one, however, I suggest upgrading the hammer first so you can have an easier time mining for ores. Apart from that, we bought a couple of seeds to plant since we already garnered enough money. At this point, I also did whatever I wanted during my free time. And once I've done enough and I'm low on stamina, then it's time to head to bed. And now, the final day for this guide. Since we got lucky and the weather was rainy during the sixth day, Clemens now comes bearing a gift for us, the final tool, the bucket. Before we go crazy and use the bucket, however, we do the usual farm chores first, as well as a trip to the Olive Hall and the museum. Once we're back at our farm, it's time to use the bucket. Now, using the bucket at the puddle scattered in the farm is the only way to get clay, which we will need for mortar, which is one of the requirements for unlocking Area 3. So we use them as much as we can while also obtaining all of the required materials for the mushroom log, which we also fix during this day. Another great use for the bucket is on the horseshoe-shaped ponds in Area 2. Using it there will net you a chest filled with appraisable bags that can either contain materials, raw or processed, or treasures you can choose to donate to the museum or decorate your own house with. Again, we gather all we can for the mushroom log, and afterwards, we do whatever floats our boat, just minding that we don't completely deplete our stamina before the day ends. And that's it for how to best manage the first 7 days of your venture in Olive Town. Now, what to focus on after that? Well, you can go and purchase pets and mounts in the animal shop, purchase more trees for your orchard, befriend the villagers, upgrade your tools, unlock Area Tree of the Farm. Really, the list does go on. What I suggest that you guys focus on is crafting sprinklers in the farm. It is pretty useful and will save you a lot of time with managing your crops. You only need 5 iron bars and 3 silver ones to craft a single sprinkler. As to where to place it, do so in a way that it is surrounded by crops. The sprinklers will only water your plants early in the morning though, before you exit the house. So if you craft and place them during the day, you'd have to wait the next day for them to function. Now, before I end this video, I would just like to show you guys the stats from my game by the 7th day. And that about does it for today's video. I hope you guys found this useful, and I'll see you all in the next one. As always, I'm open for questions as well as suggestions. Just leave those in the comment section below, and I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, you guys know the drill. Dream on, fly on. Bye-bye now. Keep safe, everyone. Stay at home.